I'm doing really well. How are you? Here we are on the red carpet. I'm feeling all right. Yeah, I don't feel nervous anymore. I'm just going to go in there and see what happens. So, you know, I have Oscar in my pocket to bring me luck, and hopefully he will. So, you know, whether it goes my way or not, it should be a fun night. It's nice to see everybody.
How's it feeling with the other contestants?
Me and Phil over there have both been here before. We kind of feel a bit like veterans. Phil was here just a year ago and didn't win it. I was here 3 years ago and did win it. Who knows? It could go to either one of us. There are some crazy films on the shortlist, like really imaginative, really different animations, insane, like using animals instead of people. Mine's quite traditional. I don't know. Hopefully the judges will go for it. If they don't, they don't. We're going to have a great night.
Entering the competition has just given me a bit of a kind of kickstart. It just gave me a chance to get some media attention, to kind of feel that I was kind of in the game, which I've not felt like for a long, long time. I did a couple of little bits last year, and that felt like I was kind of tipping my toe back into it a little bit. And then after 3 years of absence, having won with Top Gun in 2010, I decided, actually, let's go back into the Done in 60 Seconds competition, because it is a great opportunity to, for minimal effort, let's be honest, to get a lot of coverage and a lot of exposure.
The Jameson Empire Done in 60 Seconds competition is your chance to release your inner Spielberg and put your filmmaking skills to the test. So what are you waiting for? Put your thinking cap on and make those 60 seconds count.
We potentially could go all the way. I know that won't be music to the ears of the people who spent months and months and months making their films, but they come to a point where you've done enough 60-second remakes and they've all done well enough to kind of feel like you've got it down to a bit of a fine art.
Ma'am, can you handle this bus?
Yeah!
Wait, Rafe, we can fix this.
How?
We just need to unite against a common enemy.
Who?
The Japanese are attacking!
Die, Americans! I know everything about jets.
Oh, shit.
He's right, I'm just the love interest.
I feel the need
for speed!
You know, I come from a filmmaking background. I did enjoy what I used to do as a freelancer in the film industry, and I've always said I'd come back to the film industry on my own terms, if you like. That might not necessarily be quite true when I come back doing a kind of Done in 60 Seconds competition. I'm glad, but I'm more probably relieved, because I would have been really disappointed had Argo not been shortlisted in the UK. So we got the most votes in the UK, and that's great. That's, you know, I wanted top five, and we got number one. Sadly, that doesn't mean we've won the competition. It just means we're through to the global final. It all starts again with the judging panel. So they have to make up their minds about it, and that's something that I can't possibly predict.
One.
So this is my script for Argo. And if you were to sit and read through this script, basically the way that the screenplay works is it should roughly be a minute per page of properly formatted screenplay. This screenplay is 5 pages long, I think it is. And the reason that that still works for me is that I always include much, much more than I can possibly ever squeeze into a minute.
So what do you have to do to enter this competition? It's simple. Step 1, pick a movie of your choice and remake it no longer than 1 minute. Step 2, don't infringe on any copyright laws, such as using footage, images, or slogans that aren't your own. Step 3, submit your film to the site. An international judging panel will pick the top 5 finalists to attend the Jameson Empire Awards, where the winner will be announced, watched, and applauded by Hollywood's finest as they receive their coveted Done in 60 Seconds award.
Yeah, here we are, Son's Children. You know, I'm a different guy. I have a beard and an Oscar, so, you know, I'm very much playing the part tonight, and, you know, we'll go in there and see what happens. There are 23 films. I've seen the UK top 5, so it's going to be a huge surprise when I see all the ones from around the world. So I'm doing everything I can. I'm kind of projecting strength and, like, Argo and Oscar and all the rest of it. The judges will then just select 5, and we'll find out tonight which 5 go through, and actually then they'll decide who goes to the awards. So 5 films will go to the awards. Hopefully, we'll be one of them. I did watch Argo, and I didn't immediately think about it as a 60-second film, but then the competition started to run and run, and it got towards the deadline, and I started to think more and more about wanting to do a 60-second film. And Argo was kind of in my mind because I'd just seen it. It was a great, great movie. And then I started thinking about how I could do it in 60 seconds, and then Argo started winning lots of awards. And suddenly I thought that was like my angle. That's my way in. I can, if Argo can go on and win lots of awards, that's the thing that I'll use as my kind of hook. And we made the film and we showed Ben Affleck winning an Oscar for Argo before the Oscar nominations were even announced. So now, like 2 months later, Argo has won an Oscar. So this whole prediction of him winning an Oscar has come true. So hopefully that's going to carry Argo and we're going to go all the way.
But you guys have managed it. Some of you have impressed Cloud Atlas, Robocop. Hello, Robocop. Argo, it's another one. Inception, The Dark Knight, all in just 60 seconds. That's an amazing, amazing feat. You should all be proud. You should all give yourselves another huge round of applause. This year, and this is the part where you get to cheer yourselves, this year we have 5 finalists from the UK, including a former winner of the competition. Ooh. I won't tell you where he is, because you, you know, can't give him a wedgie, but he's the guy who made Argo with the Argo beard. He's walking around. That's essentially him. Who is that guy? Who is that Ben Affleck guy? But that's enough preamble. Let's get on with watching your film. You're about to see Jameson Argo from the UK. Argo from the UK. The Dark Knight from Russia. Amadeus from Greece. Reservoir Dogs from Japan.
I'm feeling like totally psyched and really nervous at the same time. The judges have all just gone off to deliberate on the 23 films. Every single one of the people in there who made a film is kind of hanging on to any comment that was made about their film by any of the judges. And I got some good comments from the judges.
I thought you got some great comments.
I don't know, midway through that, I was like, this is not happening tonight. This is not happening tonight. This is not going to work. When the film was shown and they started talking, I was like, well, maybe this can happen. And then Loki came up to me and said hi and shook my hand, and so I had a chat with Tom Hiddleston, and he was lovely. He was saying, you know, it's really hard to tell a story, and I said, that's my thing. I always tell the story in 60 seconds, so I don't just put images together. I make sure the story is there, even at the expense of the gags. And he seemed to be hit with that.
Our judges, everybody. Well, here they are. That's so Tom, head of jury, won the deliberations quite quick.
They were very quick. Yeah. But well done to everybody today. It's amazing, an amazing night.
Okay, so
we were just saying how impressed we were with the vision and the commitment and the attention to detail to come up with some of the ideas that you came up with. It's very, very impressive, and you haven't got producers breathing down your neck with deadlines, so it's even more impressive. So well done, just wanted to say that.
So, the first person through the Sundays, Jameson Empire Awards, and this is in no particular order, as we said, is, I know it, Argo. Former winner, of course. So you've been here. This is not your first rodeo.
I've done this before.
Yeah.
And
how does this feel now?
I was about 10 times more nervous this time around than I was last time.
Because you've won before?
Partly because I've won before. Because the competition is just unbelievably strong. It's been so kind of creative. Mine's very much a kind of traditional, tell the story, throw in a few gags, try and do it as well as you possibly can. there's so much kind of great creativity out there, and I thought, is there room for Argo? And amazingly, there is. So I'm unbelievably stoked.
I have to say, sorry, your moustache is so big. There you go. Sorry, sort of out. Thank you. Mark Hampton, everybody.
Fucking A. Look at that. We're through. Unbelievably stoked. In no way a sure thing, but amazing. Amazing.
We're not going to win, is my gut feeling. I don't think we're going to win it. I think the competition is very, very strong. The finalists are very, very diverse, and the judges' reactions to some of the others were gushing, really gushing. They said nice things about Argo, but Argo is quite a traditional remake. You remake a film, you throw in some gags, and you do very much a kind of same sort of style. Some of the others have really gone out there, you know, using animals instead of people, mashing up different films, animating a sci-fi. They are really imaginative, they are really different, and to be completely honest, they have put a hell of a lot more effort into their films than into mine. I took 10 days to turn around, and those guys have been working months on their films.
Mark!
Hi, Mark!
Mark!
Hi!
We have an interview, Mark!
Hello!
How are you doing?
I'm doing really well, how are you?
Alright,
here we are on the red carpet. I'm feeling alright.
The five finalists tonight are just phenomenal films. I mean, I'd say it's a bigger challenge to tell the entire story of a film in 60 seconds than it is in the sort of nearly 3 hours that a lot of the big Oscar winners were running at this year. So no, it's really, really good stuff.
Yeah, Argo was fun. There's a lot, I mean, that's the thing, is really hard because you're not comparing like for like. There are so much variety. So, you know, there's animation against real, you know, action film. And so it was hard, but, you know, there were some very clear standout, I think, kind of films that took our breath away a bit, to be honest.
As you can see, all our five finalists are all different flavours of awesome and utterly insane, but brilliant. And I will say this, the votes on who the winner is were unanimous, because it's brilliant.
And the winner is?
What did I say earlier? Blade Runner's going to win? Guess he won. Blade Runner. I feel really pleased. I got it right. It's a small consolation. They've done it. It's all done. Done in 60 seconds is done. So they went up on stage, and I knew I wasn't going to win, but my heart was still absolutely pounding. And then it went to Blade Runner, which is what I thought. It's great. I mean, I have the benefit of having done all this before, so I don't have the kind of wave. I feel really bad for the other guys on the table who are like, this is their first time at the awards, and then it's disappointing. Obviously, it's disappointing, but I wasn't expecting to win, as you know.
Especially, I love the short movie, the 60-second. Wasn't that amazing? I've never seen that before, and I thought that was so exciting, such a great idea. And also, it made me feel as though my whole career feels like one of those bang. You know, it's gone in 60 seconds.
Next for me, I'm working on a feature film. I'm writing a script for a feature film, so that's my thing. That's the thing that I've been doing for a little while, and this was kind of an aside, which I thought would kind of get some publicity. It's done a bit of that. It's put me in a room with all these amazing people, and so I'm pleased to be here. And that was always the goal. The goal is always to get this far, be at the awards tonight, and here we are. So I can't be disappointed.
So what happened?
There's an asteroid heading for Earth.
It's gonna be Armageddon.
Oh, please.
Sorry, it's a hostage situation in Iran.
We gotta get them out of there. Anyone got any ideas? Anyone? Bueller?
Get me Hollywood on the line.
So I need a script for a movie, but the movie doesn't even exist?
How about this?
Not quite right. Perfect.
We go in there as the film crew from an award-winning movie.
How do you know it will work?
Two Oscars, sir.
Gentlemen, you're in the movie business with the CIA.
You're going to be the crew to an award-winning movie.
So it's a film within a film?
They've canned your movie.
Let's go. We're not Americans.
This is going to be a great movie. It's called Argo.
It's going to be fantastic.
Let's okay. Ben Affleck?
Argo, fuck yourself. Hey, Matt Damon, I got two of them. How do you like them apples?